Lastly, an adjacency matrix can be used. In computer science, a matrix is essentially a 2D array, but the lists inside are all the same length. A matrix can also be called a rectangular array. When you look at it, it looks like a rectangle. The adjacency matrix is actually really similar to the adjacency list. The indices in the outer array still represent nodes with those IDs, and the list inside still represents which nodes are adjacent. However, these inner lists represent information in a slightly different way. Before, the list contained just the IDs of adjacent nodes. Now, the inner list has one slot for every node in the array, where node IDs map to array indices. If there's an edge between these two nodes, a 1 goes into the array. If there's no edge, a 0 is present. You might notice that the diagonal, or the place on every line where the row number equals the column number, is always 0. This value would only be 1 if there was an edge that started and ended with the same node, but we don't have any of those in our graph. You should also note that a single edge shows up twice in the matrix. For example, this edge shows up when the row is 0 and the column is 1, and also when the row is 1 and the column is 0. Which method of representation you use depends on what makes the most sense for you and what operations you'll be performing the most often. If you're looking at node degree or the number of edges connected to a particular node, the adjacency list will probably be the fastest.